First of all, let us understand the meaning of trigonometry. The literal meaning of the word trigonometry is the science of measuring the sides and the angles of triangles. In fact, the word trigonometry is originated from the Greek word tri, that means three, gonia means angle, and the metron means measurement. Precisely, we can define trigonometry as the branch of mathematics which studies of the relationships between the sides and angles of right angle triangle. Now the question is why we should study trigonometry, and the answer is trigonometry plays an important role in the study of astronomy, surveying, navigation and engineering. Nowadays it is also used to predict stock market trends. Now a question arises, that is, what are actually trigonometric ratios? And the answer is, the ratios of the sides of a right angle triangle with respect to its acute angles are called trigonometric ratios or T ratios. The three sides of a right angle triangle give six trigonometric ratios, namely sine, cosine, tangent, cosecant, secant and cotangent. Dear students, let us understand the trigonometric ratios in a better way. As you can see on the screen, there is a right angle triangle AOB, right angled at O. That means angle O is a right angle, that is 90 degree. Let us assume that angle OAB is theta, where theta is greater than 0 degree but less than 90 degree. Yes, you have guessed it right, that is theta is an acute angle. Dear students, one thing you must keep in your mind, that the side opposite of the considered acute angle, that is theta, is called perpendicular, whereas the side adjacent to angle theta is called base. And as you know very well, that the side opposite to right angle is known as hypotenuse. Now we can define six possible ratios among the three sides of the triangle AOB, which is known as trigonometric ratios. So let us see that. The first ratio is sine of angle theta, that is simply sine theta, and it is equal to the side opposite to angle theta, that is OB, divided by hypotenuse, that is AB. So we can say that sine theta is equal to perpendicular by hypotenuse, which is equal to OB by AB. The second ratio is cosine of the angle theta, or simply we can say cos theta. It is equal to the side adjacent to angle theta divided by hypotenuse. It means cos theta is equal to OA by AB, that is base by hypotenuse. And the third ratio is the tangent of the angle theta, or simply we can say tan theta. That is equal to the side opposite to the angle theta, that is OB, divided by the side adjacent to the theta, that is OA. So we can say that sin theta is equal to perpendicular by hypotenuse, cos theta is equal to base by hypotenuse, and the tan theta equal to perpendicular by base. Now on the screen we have another three ratios. The first one is cosecant of angle theta, or simply cosec theta. It is actually the inverse or reciprocal of sin theta, which is equal to the hypotenuse divided by the side opposite to theta, that is OB. So we can say that cosec theta is equal to AB by OB, which is just the inverse of sin theta, which was OB by AB. The next ratio is secant of the angle theta, or simply sec theta, which is equal to the hypotenuse divided by the side adjacent to angle theta, that is OA. So we can say that sec theta is equal to AB by OA, which is the inverse of the cos theta, which we have discussed earlier. The last ratio is cotangent of the angle theta, or simply cot theta. It is actually the inverse of tan theta. So you can see on the screen that is cot theta is equal to side adjacent to theta divided by the side opposite to theta, which is OA divided by OB. Dear students, these three ratios are the inverse of the first three ratios which we have discussed on the previous screen. So we can say that cosec theta is equal to H by P, which is the inverse of sin theta. Sec theta is equal to H by B, which is the reciprocal of cos theta and the cot theta is b by p which is the inverse of tan theta. Students, let us summarize whatever we have learnt so far in this chapter. The first ratio is sin theta, that is perpendicular by hypotenuse and can be written as p by h. Number 2, cos theta, that is equal to base by hypotenuse and can be written in short b by h. And then tan theta, that is equal to perpendicular by base, and in short we can write that p by b. The rest three ratios are the reciprocal of the first three, that is cosec theta, which is the reciprocal of or inverse of sin theta and can be written as hypotenuse by perpendicular, and in short h by p. In number 5 we have sec theta, that is hypotenuse by base, and can be written h by b, which is the inverse of cos theta. And the last ratio is cot theta, which can be written as base by perpendicular, and that is equal to b by p, which is the inverse of tan theta. Let us have a quick look of about some important points about trigonometric ratios. Number 1, each trigonometric ratios is a real number and has no unit. Number 2, the value of each of the trigonometric ratios of an angle does not depend on the size of the triangle. It only depends on the angle. And number 3, if one of the trigonometric ratios of an acute angle is known, then the remaining trigonometric ratios of that angle can be easily determined. Dear students, before ending this video, let us have practice time. So we have a question on the screen. If cos theta equal to 3 by 5, then find the values of tan theta and cosec theta. It is given that cos theta equal to 3 by 5. Let PQR be the right triangle such that angle QPR equal to theta, as you can see right side of your screen. Let us assume that PQ equal to 3 units and PR equal to 5 units. Then by using Pythagoras formula, we can calculate the length of QR, that will be equal to square root under PR square minus PQ square, and that will finally becomes 4 units. So the length of QR is 4 units. Now dear students, we know that tan theta is equal to perpendicular by base. Perpendicular means opposite side of angle theta, and base means adjacent side of angle theta, that is perpendicular by base. So it will be equal to QR by PQ, that means 4 by 3. So tan theta is equal to 4 by 3. And cosec theta is equal to hypotenuse by perpendicular. Hypotenuse is the longest side of the right angle triangle, you know very well. And the opposite side means the perpendicular, which is the opposite side of angle theta. So it will be equal to cosec theta equal to PR by QR, as you can see from the figure. So cosec theta is equal to 5 by 4. Dear students, in this video we have started to learn the chapter Introduction to Trigonometry and have discussed about trigonometric ratios, which is the first topic of this chapter. In the next video we shall try to solve the exercise questions of your NCERT book. Till then, keep learning, and thanks for your time.